Hello, my name is Adrian Young and I work at Fluke Networks, and along with my colleague today, Amanda, we're going to talk you through the DSX-5000 CableAnalyzer. The analyzer actually comes in two parts. There's a module and then there's the mainframe. The mainframe is part of the Versiv platform. What makes it a DSX-5000 is the module that we put in the back. The advantage of going to a modular platform, for instance, is if I grab over here, I can grab an OTDR module and slot an OTDR module in and turn it into a full-blown OTDR tester. Putting the module back in is quite simple. You'll find on the side of the instrument here that there are a couple arrows, and what you'll do, and I'll get Amanda to do this, you just slide it in, point it into the two arrows there, drop it down, push the ears down, and you are good to go.
So what are these RJ45s for?
So this RJ45 here is your alien crosstalk communication channel. So if you're doing alien crosstalk testing and you used our previous tester, the DTX1800, you know that you'd have to buy separate modules. That's not the case with the DSX-5000. The alien crosstalk is actually built into the tester. This other RJ45 connection here on the side allows you to connect to our cloud service called LinkWare Live. That means you can now upload your results remotely from wherever you are. You don't have to take the instrument back to the office and download them into the LinkWare PC. On the other side, there is also a USB port, and you can put a USB Wi-Fi dongle on there to transmit those results, but a little bit more on that later. So, looking at the instrument here, what comes with it? Well, there's also a remote unit as well. In addition to that, we got our permanent link adapters, and in the bag here, we have our channel adapters.
So which adapters do I use?
So the permanent link adapters are typically used by the contractor who's certifying a cabling system for a warranty application. That is a system which is a patch panel to a patch panel or a patch panel to an outlet. The channel adapters are typically used less frequently, mostly by end users troubleshooting cabling systems. That is, that's a cabling system that has the equipment cords, the patch cords in place. So the channel test is an entire end-to-end system. Now, how long do these permanent link adapters last? The tips are rated to typically 5,000. But one that's unique thing here is you can actually replace these tips. So you can actually purchase additional tips that just slide on the end here to extend the life of these permanent link adapters. One very important thing to remember, in the bag, you're going to find this little red notice that says stop. It's really important that you register your unit online, especially if you bought the gold package, which is our maintenance package, which includes a free annual calibration. So don't forget to register your unit. Okay, so let's look at the instrument in a little bit more detail. I'm going to move the adapters out of the way for this. So I'm going to pass those to you. I'm going to place the remote adapter. I have this little handy stand that we use at exhibitions. Typically, you're not going to need this in the field because most of the time you're going to attach the straps here and they're going to hang from the jumper rings on your rack, or you're just going to put it on your cart. So here's our instrument here, and we're ready to go. One of the first things that you're going to want to do, though, out of the box, is check the software version. We are constantly updating the firmware in this instrument, and these firmware updates add additional enhancements as well as minor bug fixes that we may have come across. So Amanda, to do that, go ahead and tap the tools icon for me from the home screen. And just like your cell phone, you're going to swipe up and tap version information. So on this screen here, you're going to see the serial number, but no calibration date. What you're looking at here is the serial number of the mainframe. The module has its own serial number. So go ahead and tap module for me. So now we see the calibration date. Remember, the mainframe is just the operating platform. The measurement system is the module itself. The calibration is required every 12 months, and that calibration date will be stored on your test report and can be reviewed by your customer. And customers have been known to reject test results when the calibration is not within that 12-month period. An enhancement to this tester is out of the box. That calibration date doesn't start ticking until the first time you hit the test key. Okay, so we checked the software version and we are good to go. So I think the next thing we'll do is, let's do something simple like, how do I adjust the date and time? Remembering that this unit is manufactured on the West Coast here of the United States of America. So I'm gonna cheat here. I'm gonna press the home key. And then I'm gonna get Amanda to tap tools again for me. And then just gently swipe up the screen. And you should be able to see date and time. There we go. If you tap date and time for me, it's really important to make sure that you set the date and time. It seems a little bit obvious, but this date and time is going to be stored with every test report that you've done. If you're in a different part of the world, you could be off by 23, 24 hours even. So you could even have the wrong day on there. And customers have started looking at test reports and the security logs of their buildings to see if the results actually match up. So it's very important to do the date and time. So that's some of the basics of the instrument here. What else comes with the instrument? Let me get this bag of goodies here for you. So there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. There's straps, there's USB cores, there's the terminators for the alien crosstalk testing. But the one thing I want to point out is the headset here. So this headset, and you get two of them, will allow you to talk to the other person at the other end. So Amanda could be 30 meters, 66 feet away, in a different closet, in a different office, and I can actually talk to her over the cabling system that I'm testing. On the remote unit here, you'll see that there is a talk button, and that's how Amanda would actually cue and talk to me. On the tester here, there's no talk button. What you would do is you would press the button on the headset here, and that would initiate the talk set. One other thing to remember also is you need to charge this unit. When it arrives, it's probably going to have about 35% charge in it. Now, I've charged it fully today just for this shoot here. We're not allowed to ship this from the factory fully charged. I wish we could, but we're not allowed to. So don't forget to plug this in. From a 0% battery status, expect 4 hours to charge it up to 100% with the instrument off. If you've got the instrument powered on, it's about 6 hours. So you can charge and use this instrument at the same time.
Now, is there something that customers might not know about this product?
There's all sorts of funny little things about this product, but the one that always intrigues me when I demonstrate this product is talking about battery status. Again, the battery status on this is great. Despite this LCD, you're going to get 8 to 10 hours of life out of this instrument. But what about the battery status on the remote here? If I power on the remote here, all the lights are going to come on, and what it's doing now is it's doing a self-check. Within about 8 or 9 seconds, all these lights are going to go out, the pass comes on, and then the lights that light up now indicate the battery status of the remote unit. I think that's a useful feature, and customers are often surprised to find out that something like that is available in the remote unit there. So with that said, let's set up the tester with a Category 5E permanent link test.